Hello and welcome to Let's Play My Latest Project. A nice little game, Little Nightmares. I've been looking forward to this game for ages, and I thought it looked interesting, so let's start and see what happens. And so it begins. Darkness, mist, and something emerging from that mist. But what is it? Come on, come out. Don't be shy. It's a person. Actually, you can just stay there. That's all right, don't come closer. I don't know about this. It was a nightmare. I wonder who that was. So, this is us. Oh, we're playing already. And I was sleeping in a suitcase. Okay. So, our character is really, really small. Like a doll. Wearing a sort of Coraline raincoat. I like it. And I've got a can. I love this can. Actually, no, I don't. It's rubbish. I'm going to throw it away. I want a better can. Something with tomato soup. Now, someone's hung their washing up there. If that's our washing, it's a very, very silly place to hang it. It's too far out of reach. We're only small. What were they? I just saw things. Things with triangular heads. And they ran away. Where'd they go? And I have a lighter.
I shall light my way in darkness.
And can I set fire to this lantern? Come on. Oh, there we are. What's that done? Is that some sort of save? Yes, that's right. I don't know what I'm doing. This is all guesswork.
Let's try and learn the buttons. No, oh, we can crouch. Here we are.
This is a blind Let's Play. I've never played this before. All I know
is that I saw a trailer for it a while ago, and I've been waiting for it to come out for ages.
A rare occurrence where a game has caught my eye.
I mean, look at those shadows.
It's my understanding that this isn't a long game,
and that makes it perfect to Let's Play.
We'll get through it nice and quick before we get on with the next main project. But I hope people enjoy it. From what I've seen of it, this looks like exactly the kind of game that I'd like. Kind of like Oddworld meets Tim Burton. I don't know if this character can fight at all. We're going to have to be really careful and use all these shadows. We're going to have to hide.
Some of our antagonists are weird and creepy.
And you know what the worst thing is? Right now, we are going through a heat wave. So I hope you're appreciating this. I am dying to try and bring you this video. Melting in the sun. Because of course when you're recording you have to turn off your fan and shut the windows.
And I'm doing it all for you. And what is that?
I see a thing around the corner. Is it a little person?
Is it a bad guy?
No, it's a statue. Can I pick it up? I've got a statue. What do we do with this?
I shall keep it and call it Bertha. Come on, Bertha, let's go.
Oh no! I killed Bertha!
Sorry. A moment's silence for Bertha.
Right, that's enough.
We have no time for silence.
For there are chairs suspended in the air for some reason.
Well, that's rather odd.
Okay. Was it? I walked across the light and it disappeared.
There's a bed. This bed's much better than my suitcase. Maybe I should live here.
My new bedroom.
This is brilliant.
Yay. I'm going to jump on my bed. Hey, I said,
I'm going to jump on my bed. Just to break it in.
Good. This is an excellent bed. Let's go.
Highly sprung. Did I just get a trophy for jumping on my bed? Finally, a trophy for achievement. Oh dear. Someone seems to have hanged themselves. He was obviously very lonely.
There's toilet paper next to that mattress.
He must have been
crying a lot.
And apparently I'm too small to reach this door handle, but I think
I can pull the chair. And I can. Poor man. The chairs are too small for him.
The chairs are too big for me. But now, I can get through the door.
In many games, doors have been my greatest enemy. But not this game! We can outwit the doors with chairs!
And what on earth is this on the floor? Ugh. Some weird black slime. I don't know about this.
Nothing down here. Can we
look in the fridge? I hope there's nothing horrible in it. Oh, just another one of those triangle head things. And someone has put their shoes in the fridge. I mean, honestly, who does that? Probably the guy hanging in the other room. The strange little triangle head creature hid his shoes in the fridge.
And the man couldn't find his shoes and he couldn't live in a world without his shoes.
So he had to hang himself. There was no other option. And what is this?
Oh dear.
There appears to be a weird little leech thing coming towards me. Ugh.
Uh-oh, is that another one?
Stay away from me, you.
Oh no.
They're all over the place.
Leave me alone.
You don't want to eat me. I'm mostly just a raincoat with legs. Now please excuse me whilst I pull this switch. And we've opened the door. Oh, hang on. I see a lantern. Can we light the lantern?
Uh-oh. There's a thing coming towards me.
No, stay away. I'm trying to light the lantern. No, don't pick it up.
Oh, God.
How do I do it again? I've gone the buttons.
Come on.
Oh, great. Well done. You just got killed by a leech.
Aw, poor whatever my character's name is.
I believe she's called Six. Why is she called Six? I don't know.
But what I do know is we have to stay far away from those horrible leeches.
Because if they get to you, you're dead.
Stay away from me. Right, this time,
let's try and figure this out. Oh, there we are. I think it's a checkpoint. Or a collectible. Ah, remember the days when computer games used to have booklets that told you what all the things were? They don't do that anymore. I guess they're saving the rainforest.
I'm not.
I prefer printed bank statements and books over ebooks.
And etc. Oh dear.
The door has closed behind me, but at least those leeches can't get to me now. As long as there's nothing horrible behind here, I feel safe. Triangle head thing.
Oh God, no!
This is like the beginning of Silent Hill, they're surrounding me.
No, leave me alone.
Ah! This is horrible. Why did I decide to play this game?
Why can't I ever choose to play nice games?
Oh.
And I died. Typical. Oh dear, we've got to do this again.
Okay, leeches, stay away from me.
You don't want to mess with me because I've got a very, very small lighter. Yeah, and I'll use it without discrimination.
Let us bounce. Bounce to safety.
Right, this time.
Ah!
This time, let's not jump down the hole because that's stupid.
Doing.
Lantern over there.
This time we know what we're doing.
I guess really we should feel thankful that we're only getting leeches because I happen to know that later on it gets so much worse. I mean really, how did Six find herself in a place like this? It's the last place you'd want to be.
I'd say I want to go home, but that might mean going back to my suitcase and, well really, I'd rather not.
And here I am thinking I had problems. I had a little argument the other day with my dad.
Saying, did you move the PlayStation 4?
Yes, I was using it. And basically he doesn't want the PlayStation 4 moving at all.
For some reason.
Leave it where it is. And seeing as I make videos and everything, it would make it incredibly difficult to actually record or do anything. So I just said, fair enough. But that means that I decided to go out and buy my own PlayStation 4. I mean, yes, it's a pretty large price to pay just so someone can have their wires and everything in the exact place where they were originally, but at least this way I'll have access to it all the time without having to borrow it. That's one of the main reasons I stopped doing Fallout 4, because it's just too difficult to get hold of the console. But now I shall have one permanently set up in my room.
So, yay!
And how on earth are we going to get to the other side?
Run!
Can we jump?
Doing?
Yep, we can jump, and we didn't make it. Too slow. I mean, come on. I'm used to being spoon-fed in games these days. Maybe we can... There we go. I found out how to run. So we've got to try and make it to the other side really quickly. Okay.
Here we go.
Ready. Hold square to sprint. Oh, thanks for that.
Come on!
And we made it! Great! See? I knew I could do it. And now we find ourselves in a dark room with a light bulb that didn't seem to be doing very much at all. Now, can we go through here? Triangle head! Okay, I guess we better follow him.
With our new running ability!
I think that's going to come in handy later on.
As we encounter some things we're definitely going to be running from.
Let's go through this cartoon mouse hole.
Ooh.
This place seems a bit brighter.
Uh-oh. What is that?
Maybe I should go back. All things considered, my suitcase didn't seem that bad. No, I suppose we better go and find out what that thing was. Because that is a good idea. Thank goodness for this conveniently placed makeshift rope. Now, let's see. Any
horrible people in here?
No? Good.
And now we find ourselves in the toilet paper room. At last.
Hey, a ratty. Where'd it go? Sometimes it just seems like every single time I meet someone, they run away. It's just so lonely being 1.5 foot tall. Now we have an electrified door. Let's see. Okay, we've got a trailing wire leading behind this door. So... aha! We've got a switch.
A switch which I can't reach. But... we can use the crate of toilet paper.
I mean, seriously, why is there so much toilet paper in this game? Yeah, I suppose it's good to be prepared for an emergency, but still. Okay.
Oh, I can hear ticking, so that means we're on a timer.
Let's get through this door. Ooh, a seesaw. I can barely see anything. Can we jump up here? I wonder what we're going to find. Probably more toilet paper.
But you never know.
Ooh, the electricity's back. And I found a wind-up toy. Got some blocks and some swings and a ball. A ball which is moving around.
Who pushed this ball towards me?
Ooh, train. I guess
a children type person lives here.
A child. And they keep them secured by electric doors.
Of course.
How do we turn these ones off? Can we see any switches?
Maybe we can climb up here?
Okay. Nope, can't do that.
What about this one?
No. Maybe we have to go to the previous room. Because there appears to be an opening here which leads back. But why else would you want to go back unless we needed to go back?
Let's turn the power off again.
And then get to the next section. What kind of child needs electric barriers? Either the people that live here are disturbed, or the child is bad. They need containing. And good old electric shock treatment is a tried and tested method. My mum used to be a childminder. She knows all about this stuff. You got the fences, the turrets, the guard dogs, the spotlights. And yes, the door is not electrified. We made it! Now what?
Oh, we made it just in time.
Can we go into any of these doors? Nope.
Hmm.
So I guess this place is some kind of prison.
Oh God.
There appears to be an eye.
And it wants to look at me.
Can we sneak by this way?
Solid snake style.
I think we can. Good.
Oh, that was close.
Too close. Okay.
Nothing over there.
Let's go. Oh, seriously? Oh no, what happened to her? Poor Six. Okay, we're gonna try that again, and this time we're not gonna waste any time. I refuse to be defeated by some electric eye.
An eye that disintegrates you if it looks at you.
I wonder if it can see you if you've got your light on. Okay, let's
be careful. Same as before.
But this time we're not going to get caught. We can do this. Right. Now's our time. Let's go. And we just made it. Ha! You stupid eye. I bet you thought I was going to walk behind the beds and stuff.
But you've got a nice big blind spot right underneath you.
A blind spot I shall gladly exploit. Now, what's up here? Okay, so we've got a door on this side. Can it be opened?
It can,
but I'm just gonna check the rest of this room first.
Because you never know.
There might be something to help us on our quest.
Or maybe not, but
let's look anyway. There could be marshmallows and pogo sticks or something really amazing in this room, and we find a bed.
With a picture of the scary eye.
And some weird black gunge. Oh, but we found a statue.
Is that like a spirit escaping or something?
Oh well, never mind. Let's jump on the bed and then leave. How do you like this, eye? And you can't do anything about it.
Right, let's go.
Oh, but is there anything behind the door? Nope.
Okay. Back to the other room.
No prisoner's ever going to escape with that thing down there. Good thing it can't hear me running around. What's in here? Uh-oh. I'm gonna hide under the bed. That thing looks creepy. Look at its weird arms. I'm gonna sneak past, and hopefully it won't turn around. We're in some kind of nursery.
Don't see me.
Okay, I think we're gonna be okay. Let's get out of here. I think it's safe to say the people that live here are not normal.
But what is normal?
Well, not looking like that!
I'm sure we'll be seeing plenty more of him later.
For now, let's just sneak away like the cowardly survivor we are. Into this ventilation shaft.
Oh, getting dark.
I keep expecting something to jump out at us at any second.
But we're safe for now. Famous last words.
More ratties. Oh. Are you okay, Six? She doesn't look so well. I wonder what's going on.
Uh-oh.
This looks like a place we're gonna have to try and keep our head down. Not again. I don't want to be caught by one of those things out there. Let's keep going. Who's that?
that.
Oh no, hide!
That person looks like they might just be a child. Oh, they threw us something to eat.
Thank you.
Oh, we better eat it right now.
Nom. Nom 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 nom. Nom 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 nom.
Stale bread, my favourite. Is that better?
Thank you, person. You are my friend.
So I guess not everyone's bad in this place. Some people are okay.
And they give you bread.
Anything in here? No?
Let's move on.
Oh dear, I don't know about this. Scary showers are always a bad sign.
Ooh, can we...
Nope.
Hmm.
Can we push this? We can! Over the edge.
Nice.
Oh, damn. Yeah, nice one. Make a massive sound. Make sure everyone knows that we're here.
Good going, stupid. I mean, I know you're just doing what I'm telling you to do, but,
still. Be careful.
This place is too dangerous. We have to be on our toes at all times.
The only thing that can make it all better is a lantern.
Like this one here.
I said, like this one. Here.
There we go.
Oh, so much do I have to put up with.
Let's try and jump across here. And we made it. Now, oh.
Well, that's lucky.
I thought we were going to have to jump towards those lockers. But apparently we have to go up the chain.
It's quiet here.
Eerie. Just the low rumbling ambience, like the old Aperture laboratories. Now let's see what we can see. Okay, we've got a couple of switches over there.
Switches, buttons, levers. I love those.
We must find out what they do. Right now!
Does this do anything?
No? Okay.
Let's climb up here. So Six is a very small character in a world inhabited by very large characters. But at least she has ladders and things, just her size. The scale seems to be all over the place, but I suppose you can't look for logic in a crazy world like this. Now, what's this one do? Oh, okay, that brings it towards me. And that makes it go further away.
Oh, come back!
I think we're gonna have a ride. Let's push it in the other direction and run! Oh no!
No!
Ouch! That looked painful. Oh no. We're all the way back here. Okay, let's
get back nice and quick.
Hey!
I thought that lantern was supposed to be like a checkpoint or something.
Maybe not. At least we know where we're going this time. I might as well show this off, but I think in future videos, if it puts me back quite a long way, then I will probably edit it out and continue the recording from where I died. I see another electrical door there, so I suppose we're trying to find a switch to turn the power off.
But first, we must deal with the kind of platforming that Lara Croft can only dream of.
Six is like Lara Croft and Nathan Drake all rolled up into one.
Also, this lantern has betrayed me.
Do you have any idea how long it's going to take me to get all the way back up there? Possibly a minute, maybe less.
I have a good mind to unlight you, but that would be counterproductive.
So, let's just climb the chain.
And never speak of this again.
We know what we're doing this time, so nothing can go wrong. Unless it does.
In which case, bugger.
But we shall try.
We shall try not to fall down.
Because that's a long way.
I mean, really, this is just part one of the game.
And so far, she's fallen all the way down, she's been sizzled by the robotic eye, she's been killed by a leech. What next? All right, let's do this. Try and do it right this time. Okay, it seems to move a bit slower if you don't push it all the way. So, just a bit and we made it. Oh, hope it didn't stop halfway.
Come on.
And we're across. Nice. See, I wasn't worried. Well, maybe a bit. Ooh, and we found a switch. And another electric door. So let's try and climb up these filing cabinets.
I wonder if any of the files are in fact gaming manuals to tell us what on earth is going on.
Why are we in a prison place? Why is Six so small?
Why is she called Six? Are there others? 1 to 5?
7 to unknown? And what's with the weird giant things with the creepy arms? The little pyramid head people. What do the lanterns do? And those strange spirits disappearing from the smashed statues?
I must know!
Like I said, it's only part one. I'm sure I'll find out.
And I feel I'm making progress.
Anything in here?
Nope.
Fine.
I didn't want to open it anyway.
Okay, I think we're going to have to interact with this in a minute, but first, I see another lantern, and I saw something inside here.
It's a triangle head. Where's it going? I mean, really, I go out of my way to rescue it. The least I expect is a little bit of thanks.
Well, I'm annoyed now, so I'm going to have to push this off the edge, because that's the kind of crazy, wide-eyed person I am. And after I finish recording, I think I'm going to sit in the fridge for a bit, because it's so hot.
I'm going to sit in the fridge, and I'm going to leave my shoes in there as well, for obvious reasons. Now, where are we going? Oh, we're right back here again. And I suppose, now that we've turned the power off, we should be able to go through that other electrical door. Oh no. Not you guys! Go up! Oh, come on! Damn!
Okay. Okay, it's not made me go all the way back to the beginning.
The power's still off, so if we can get past these horrible leech things, we should be able to make it to that door.
Now it's not electrified.
Leave me alone. I just want to get out of this place.
It's weird. The only nice thing in the entire level so far has been that boy that gave me some bread. I should have busted him out and he could have been my partner.
Uh-oh.
Not again.
A game with the eye. Alright, let's do the same as we did before. Sneak back here.
Uh-oh. We'll walk past all these boxes.
Oh, they're going side to side. Are we on a boat? A sort of prison boat. Come on, I. Look over here. And we get ready to run! Ooh. Some weird dolls. I wonder if they were alive too, before the eye looked at them. I mean, I don't know what Six is supposed to be. Is she some sort of doll, or is she just a very small person? And once again, we seem to have evaded the evil eye. Nice. Uh-oh, what's going on? Jump! Oh, we got this in the way, come on. Oh, actually, jump onto the box and we've done it. That was too close. Bet we survived. I wonder what the game is going to throw at us next. Hey, some friends. Come back. This all looks rather conclusive. Trophy earned the prison. So I'm going to end part one of Little Nightmares. Join me again for part two. Bye.